Okay, hi. I'm Mandy Loss. I'm a certified athletic therapist out of the University of Manitoba. So I'm here today to teach you guys about some taping techniques, some basic taping techniques. I've given you the handouts, which are not 100% going to match what I have on the slides here, but I'll make sure that we cover everything in here, okay? So I don't want to stand up here and talk too much. I'd rather you guys get some practical stuff in there, some practice taping ankles. We're going to do ankles, arches, wrists, and thumbs today, okay? So the big question is, why bother with taping, right? So your athletes are going to ask for it. Sometimes they're going to ask for it just because they want to be cool and that's what they want to do. Other times they're going to ask for it because they have had an injury and they need it. So it does protect injuries. It does make the athlete feel better from a psychological component. So, you know, athlete rolls their ankle and they come back, they're coming back from an injury. They may not feel 100% confident in that ankle. So you're going to want to tape it and that'll help them a little bit more, okay? It may be advised by their doctor or the therapist that they've seen that they need to be taped. So, you know, some teams aren't fortunate enough to have a therapist with them all the time. So that'll be perfect for you guys to know how to do that as well for them. So it doesn't, these tape jobs that I'm showing you today don't necessarily prevent injuries from happening, but they can protect injuries from happening, okay? So, you know, a guy coming in, he's like really, he's never sprained his ankle before, but he just wants it to get taped. Chances are that tape job's not going to do anything for his ankle, but if that guy is coming back from an injury and he's, you know, like it's about 80%, like things are feeling good, but just when he gets really intense, that's when things start to bug him, that tape will help with that extra maybe 10%, okay? So your general taping supplies that you should have or could have in a little kit is going to be your pre-wrap, which is this foam kind of feeling stuff. It comes in multiple different colors, so you can match it with your team if you want to, or just the plain beige color. Your skin toughener. It's important to have this, especially if you're, you know, playing in a tournament and you're going to be taping that athlete quite a bit. You want to put the skin toughener on because that's going to protect the skin. It literally makes the skin a little tougher and also makes the skin sticky so that the pre-wrap will stick to the skin and it won't slide with the tape job once they start sweating. Heel and lace pads. These are used with the tape jobs we're going to do today, just for the ankles, but it's for any tendons that are, you know, if you feel the back of your hamstrings, those tendons that are really nice and out there, that's what it protects against. So any friction against those areas, you'll want to attach, put these on before you tape. And then obviously there's tape. There's multiple different kinds of tapes. Zinc oxide or white athletic tape is the best thing to use for you guys. There's different products out there, Andover products, which is the Power Tape or Power Flex. You may have heard those terms before. It's just a different material of tape, but I just suggest you guys use the white tape. It's the most cost efficient and easiest to work with. Okay, there's also elastic tape, I've just brought these as far as for demo purposes, but you don't want to be taping ankles or supportive with any elastic tape. Okay, these are used mainly for anchors or they're used for compression, things like that. You don't want to do a stabilizing or supporting ankle tape job with these tapes, okay? Okay, so when you're preparing the skin, I'm going to talk about the ankle, but obviously this applies to every joint. So when you're preparing for taping, we have to obviously make sure that the tape is going to stick. And you have to keep in mind that your athletes are probably going to start sweating as soon as they start playing basketball. So you want to make sure that you get as good adherent as you can ahead of time and tape it well enough so that it doesn't get loose and start to fall and then becomes ineffective by the end of the game. Okay. So in that being said, you want to make sure that they don't have any lotion on their skin. Hair, do you have to get them to shave? If you're going to be taping them directly to the skin, you might want to. Eventually, after multiple tape jobs, they're just going to lose the hair on their skin anyway. And any dirt or anything like that, you want to make sure is cleaned off of their skin before you're applying any of this stuff, okay? You're going to inspect the skin to make sure that there aren't any blisters or cuts or abrasions or anything like that. If there are, you want to treat those first. So blisters, you'll put a little donut pad, which is a piece of foam with a hole in the middle, protecting that area. Abrasions, put a Band-Aid on it with, you know, polysporin and Band-Aid on it. Anything, just cover up those areas before you do the tape job. That'll protect that wound, as well as not cause any further damage to that area. Okay. Do we need to protect the skin tape adherent and or pre-wrap? There's mixed reviews about that. Some people like to tape right onto the skin. Some people will use the pre-wrap with the skin adherent. It all depends on your athlete. If you're going to be taping them a lot, I would suggest you use the pre-wrap and the skin toughener. Some athletes just don't feel like they have good enough support with that pre-wrap on them, and they want you to attach it right to their skin. Still use the skin toughener though, because that'll protect that skin. If they rip it off, they're gonna rip pieces of their skin off too, which isn't a good thing. Okay. Before you tape them, make sure you're asking if they've ever been taped before. If they have allergies to any tape adhesives, so if they've ever reacted to a Band-Aid before is the easiest one to ask them, or if they have sensitive skin. If they've got sensitive skin, then you want to be careful about using any of the skin adherent, and you'll want to just use the pre-wrap on them without the skin adherent, and that'll give them less of a chance of reacting to it. If they have reacted to tape before, if they've never been taped before, they don't know if they're allergic to it, you do a little test spot with them. Take a piece of tape, stick it on their leg or the area that's going to be taped, and let them walk around for a little bit. Get them to come back, take that tape off, and see what the skin is doing. If the skin is turning red or if it's itchy, then they're having a reaction to it. Okay? And then you can't tape them if they've got the allergy to the tape, because we don't want to irritate the skin like that. Okay? And then you got to figure out what your plan is. So finding out what their injury is, as far as if it's the ankle, did they roll it in, roll it out, for the wrist, you know, which way does it hurt? Because that's how you have to figure out how you want to tape it to prevent any further injury. So some basic rules for tape application, I kind of touched on some, but you're going to place that joint in a stable position. So for the ankle, that's going to be flexed at kind of at 90. They have to hold their foot in that position. Okay. For the wrist and the thumb, it's going to depend on which way they've hurt themselves. So, you know, if they bent their thumb backwards, we want to bring it forwards just a little bit. If they've hurt their wrist going backwards, we want to bring it out of that painful position and tape them just outside of that painful position. Okay. Another general rule is every time you're going to do a tape job, you're going to overlap the tape by half the width. So this is your tape. Every time you apply a second piece of tape, you're going to overlap it by half. Okay? That's going to prevent windows and gapping in there. Anytime, if you do it, I'll just kind of show you here quickly. If I tape this on my hand, which is not going to stick right now, and then I take another piece and I don't overlap it by half, say I just decide I'm going to be a little sloppy and leave that window here. So as it gets, it's going to be a tight tape job, and as that gets tighter in through here, this will cause a blister effect in here, because they're moving around like crazy, right? They're going to be sweating. It causes a friction spot through that area. You can get a blister, you can get a cut. That's the things you want to avoid. So always taping, overlapping by half the width of the tape every time you're doing any kind of tape job. Okay. Continuous taping, you want to avoid that if you're not using elastic tape. So that's taking this and just wrapping it around 50 times to support that wrist. Okay. Always wrap it around once, rip the tape, wrap it around a second time, rip the tape. So you're not doing that continuous rolling. That'll cut off circulation. Keep that tape roll in the hand as much as you can. So every time you're doing a tape job, putting down the tape, ripping it, you've still got the tape in your hand all the time. You're not putting it down to try and place things. I'll show you how to do that when we actually get into the practical portion of this stuff. It's fairly simple to do. And then as you're laying it down, make sure you're smoothing and molding it. We want to avoid, like, those windows was that little gapping in the thing. The other thing you want to avoid as much as possible is wrinkles, especially on the first layer of tape that you put down onto the skin, because again, wrinkles is going to allow the skin to pull into that area, can cause a blister. Okay, any questions so far? Just kind of shout out if you have questions as we go. So we'll also, continuing on with the rules, allow the tape to follow the natural contour of the skin. So don't try and force. You'll see when we do some of these, especially with the ankle, there's different angles that have to be done for heel locks and figure eights, and you're going to want the tape to go in a different way. Just let the tape go where it wants to go, and then you can kind of regroup and let it, and then redo what you need to do. That's going to prevent those windows and those wrinkles from happening some more. Okay. You'll use anchors to set your boundaries and attach other pieces of tape. I'll show you those anchors when we do them. Anchors is just going to be a strip of tape that you use that really may not have anything to do with the injury itself, but that's where the rest of the tape will attach to, so that it actually sticks for a longer period of time, as opposed to being stuck right onto the skin or right onto the pre-wrap, and then as they sweat and start moving around, it'll lose its effectiveness. Like I said earlier, taping directly onto the skin is going to give you that maximum support. It's not overly necessary if you do an efficient tape job with the pre-wrap. Okay. And if they've put heat on it, or if they put an ice pack on it before taping, don't do the tape job until they've come back. Their skin has come back to normal temperature. Just because that difference in if you put ice on it, everything constricts, and so you tape them up real good and tight. And then once they get warm, everything wants to expand as much as it can. You're going to cut off circulation. Okay. Same thing with if they're too hot. You do the tape job, you think it's nice and tight, and then they cool off a little bit, and then that tape job is like a sock, it's just going to fall off. Okay? Okay, we'll go over this just because we'll get into the other stuff after. But so post-taping, meaning as soon as you finish putting that tape on, you want to make sure that you check for things as well as soon as you're finished doing that tape job. So you're going to check circulation. Circulation is just checked by pinching the nail bed and making sure that the color comes back. If they've got nice bright nail polish on like I do, just go with the thumb pad, push in, it's going to turn white and it should turn pink right after, within 3 seconds. If it doesn't happen, then you've put the tape on too tight and you've got to take it off and try it again. Okay. You're going to manually check that support. So if that person tells you that when I get into this position here, that really hurts, once you do the tape job, you're going to take them into that position themselves. And if that tape should stop that position from, or that movement from hurting, you're going to check that, okay, is that hurt when I do that? They're going to say, no, you did a great job. It doesn't hurt in that position. That's one step. Then you need to functionally check it, keeping it sport specific. So whatever position that they're playing in basketball, you want them to go through some position specific movements that they're going to do in a game situation, with the amount of force that they would use in a game situation. So, you know, if they're going to be pushing off of somebody, it's not going to be a light little tap, because chances are they're not going to do that in a game situation. You really want to get them to test that tape job to make sure that it's doing the job it's supposed to do. Okay. Immediate follow-up instructions. That's going to be, you know, as soon as the game is over, we're going to take the tape off, put some ice on the area, things like that. There, you want them to tell you if it's too tight or too loose, and that can happen throughout the game as well. So just because you've tested them functionally and you've tested them and they're good to go at the beginning of the game doesn't mean that you can forget about them. You want to make sure that throughout the game, just a couple times, you know, is that okay? It's not too tight, not too loose, so that you don't have to adjust it. Or if it is too tight or too loose, you can make adjustments as the game goes on. Okay? Your home instructions, again, will be make sure they take the tape off. Afterwards, wash the area, inspect the area to make sure that they have no irritations, no cuts, no blisters from the tape, and icing the injury if necessary. Okay? Never sleep with that tape on. That tape is supportive and meant only for game situations. So you don't want to make sure they take it off that night. You'll tape them again the next game. You know, if you're playing late at night and first thing in the morning, make sure they're still taking that tape off. Okay? And like I said, looking for those signs of irritation. So redness, itching, blisters, cuts, things like that. Okay, so we're almost going to get into some practical stuff. I think there's a little bit more information in your handout as far as your prepping goes. I've touched on everything. We'll get into more specifics when we get into the actual tape job. So your closed basket weave is the ankle tape job I'm going to teach you today. You can use it for a newly sprained ankle. The only difference that you'll want to do with that closed basket weave with a newly sprained ankle is add some extra padding. It's for swelling control. I don't have a padding here, but like camping foam, which is like that thick, you can get it at Canadian Tire, works the best. It's not as expensive as the actual medical brand stuff, but you'll cut a horseshoe shape. So it's, I'm gonna go over here. You wanna, I don't know if you could do that on the board. I'm suck at horseshoes, but you'll basically cut it like a horseshoe. This piece might be a little bit bigger. So this is gonna go around the ankle bone for the ankle, and then this gets taped up the side of the bone on the side of the leg. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna cause compression in that area, and that's what you wanna do right after they sprain the ankle, because we wanna control the amount of swelling that's in there. If you can control, the more you can control that swelling, the quicker they're gonna come back from that injury, okay? You can also use it for their chronically unstable ankle. So those are your athletes who have had 5 or 6 ankle sprains, and doesn't matter what they do, they can turn around and they're gonna roll their ankle. So you'll wanna use this tape job for that, okay? So supplies you're gonna need for this one is your skin toughener, your pre-wrap, your heel and lace pads. Another thing I didn't mention is with the heel and lace pads, you wanna add skin lube, which you can buy like this, or you can buy a jar of Vaseline, it does the same thing. Just to add to it so that there's not, it doesn't get all sweaty and cause blisters again, okay? And then of course your white athletic tape. Who wants to be my model? Anyone? Please, someone?
Pitch, come on, you're good to go.
Good. So I need to sock off of whatever leg you want. Okay. So you can sit on the table. Yeah, that's fine right there. So it kind of shows you, I'll try and follow along step by step with your notes so that you guys know what we're doing. You can slide back.
No, this might be a
good
one.
Good one. Okay, so like I said, I've got my materials ready. I always grab everything all at the same time so it's quicker. My starting position is gonna be in as neutral position as I can get him. So he should be able to get into that 90 degrees right off the hop. If he's not there yet, chances are he's not ready to play basketball yet, okay? So you're gonna tell the athlete you hold that position the whole time. And I want you to slide down just a touch more. That's good right there. So the anchors that I talked about before, the first things after I do the spray and the wrap, I'm gonna apply. We don't wanna go into the muscle belly at all. If we go into the muscle belly, then we can affect their function and things like that. So we wanna make sure that we're below the muscle belly, which is gonna be when that calf, when the calf muscle comes down into a contour. If they've got like a good sport sock size on, usually it's at the sock line, okay? The more important anchor is gonna be the base of the fifth metatarsal, which is this nice, I know, that's a lot of anatomy there, right? It's this little bump on the side of the foot. So if you slide your finger down the outside of the foot, there's gonna be a bump there. That's the base of the fifth metatarsal. You wanna make sure that gets covered. If we don't cover that, we risk fracturing that area, which we don't wanna do.
Is that where kids really complain about that pain too?
If you do it too tight, yeah, then they'll get pain in that area. So if you, the anchors shouldn't be tight at all. They just have to be sitting on the skin. It's the other parts of the tape job that you really wanna make sure are tight. You're okay with me spraying you?
Yeah.
You've had no, you've got no allergies to anything. Have you ever been taped before?
Yes.
Okay, so you know what this is all about. Have you ever rolled your ankle before?
Multiple times.
Okay, which way did you roll it?
Any way possible.
Any way possible. Okay, so the first one I'm gonna do, which is the most common one, is the inversion ankle sprain, which is gonna be when they roll to the outside. I can't, roll out that way. Okay, so if they roll inwards this way, that's the most common sprain you're gonna get in the ankle, so that's the one I'll show you what we'll tape for, okay? So you're gonna hold your foot nice and high like that. I'm gonna spray you, this is a little bit cold. Heel and lace pads go on first, so he's got the nice tendons on the top of the foot that you can see, and then we always protect the Achilles tendon on the back of the foot. If you guys can't see, you can come in closer, I don't bite. Okay, then you take your pre-wrap. And this, same thing, it doesn't have to be excessively tight, but you do want it to be, you don't want it to be loose when it's going on, because that's going to affect the whole tape job, right? So a little bit of tension in it as you're wrapping it on. The tricky part is going to be when you're coming around the foot, you're going to notice that it's going to want to roll on you, and that's okay as long as you fix that roll before you move on with the white tape. I'll show you how, if it happens, it's called plucking it. So what happens is it may roll up or bunch in here, and then before, you just keep wrapping, and then as soon as you, before you start the tape job, you just take that piece and pluck it off, and then the roll will disappear because you've ripped it off.
Will that cause blisters,
you believe? It may, yeah. Okay, so my proximal anchors, which are going to be up just below the belly of the calf, I'm going to be kind to him and try and stay on the pre-wrap. Don't necessarily have to tape right onto the skin. If it happens, it happens, but it's not. Some people believe that you have to tape onto the skin. I'm not a believer of that. As long as you've got good tension throughout the tape job, you should be fine not doing that. Okay. So again, making sure you're overlapping by half when you do that on the top, and then I'll do my distal anchor. And this one, I just make sure, when I do this one, I'll splay his foot as well so that I'm not squishing everything together, right? So if I do it too tight, he gets like this, he's gonna get foot cramps, things like that, he's not gonna like me. So I just take my thumb as I'm applying it and I push into the foot as I wrap this around, okay? And then we rip. I've covered the base of the fifth. I'm going to do one more just to make sure that this is supported quite well. Same thing, splay it out. Okay, so there's a little bit of wrinkles in here. We want to make sure that we smooth those out before we continue. Okay, doesn't necessarily mean you have to rip it off, just means you have to make sure you're ironing out those wrinkles as you go. Okay. So for a lateral ankle sprain, the next step is the horseshoes, or the stirrups, I believe is what they're called, stirrups, in your notes. So when we're taping for a lateral ankle sprain, we want to make sure that we're pulling them, just relax the foot, 1 second. So lateral ankle sprain is going to have a tendency to want to come inwards all the time. So these stirrups are going to pull them and support them that way, okay? So what you want to do is start from the inside and pull to the outside. So, start from the inside. I hang on to that so I don't lose that tape, and then I pull up through the outside. Okay, pull and then tack it down. You don't wanna, if they've got someone who's got really, really hypermobile ankles, meaning they move like crazy, you don't wanna get them too excessively into that position, because then you're just gonna put the inside at risk. So make sure it's not excessive, but you do want to give it a good tug, because that's the most common way that they're going to do that, roll their ankle. Okay. So in your notes there, it says from medial to lateral. That's what that means, inside to outside.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So you generally do three of those, depending on the athlete though. If you're working with young athletes, they may have really tiny ankles. Two should suffice, but three is the general rule. Okay, so you go outside, or inside, I mean, sorry. Rip that tape. You can go right over top or else layer. So he doesn't have a very wide foot, so I don't want to go directly over top of each other. I want to fan it out just a little bit. So, like this one, I'm about 3/4 covering, right? It just depends on the size of the, if you've got a really big guy, then that half width is still a good rule of thumb to go by. Otherwise, we try and fit them on as best we can. Okay.
With a big guy that's maybe heavier, would you use an extra anchor too?
You could, absolutely, yeah. And even with somebody who may not be as big, but who has got really lax ankles,
yeah,
you can throw an extra one in.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so that's two, and then I'm gonna do one more. The main thing with these stirrups as well is you wanna make sure that they go in through the heel, they don't come up into the arch of the foot. I'm sorry if you're ticklish, I'm poking around like crazy. If you come up into the arch of the foot, then they're not doing their job. This movement is what they're doing, so if you go too far into the arch, they're not gonna stabilize that movement, okay? So again, pull up, tack it down. You'll see many variations to the way some people do these. They might do a horseshoe and, or a stirrup and then a closing strip, which I'll show you right now. The main thing is that these get done from the inside to the outside. Doesn't matter if you do one of those and then close it off. If you want to do it that way, if you find that the tape's not sticking well, you do one piece and then you do a closing strip on top to anchor it down. That's fine, okay? Makes the tape job a little bit bulkier. Depends on your athlete whether they'll like it or not.
So basketball is okay, alternating? That's fine too, you said?
Yeah, absolutely. So that I'm kind of following the step by step over here, but the way I usually do it is I'll do one stirrup and then I do a closing strip, which I'll show you right now, or a horseshoe, which is this way. So you come medial again, pull to the lateral side, and then just pull up. So what I'll do is I'll actually basket weave that, where I'll do one stirrup and then one horseshoe. Stirrup, horseshoe, stirrup, horseshoe. It doesn't make a difference. It may look nicer. Okay, so I'm just gonna close this, oops. Close this right off. And I'm going to close this right off, right up to the top of the tape job itself. So as I get further away from the base of the foot, my horseshoes will start closing in on themselves through the front. Okay, now comes the tricky part, your heel locks. So we see there's a little, just show everybody, there's a little window here, but we don't have to be concerned about those yet because we're not done that tape job yet, okay? So you can inspect it as you go. The main thing is you want to make sure you've got no windows kind of up and through the foot at this point, or up into the leg at this point. Down here we're okay because we still have heel locks and figure eights to do, which is what I'm going to show you now. Come back this way, thank you. So, heel locks, what that's doing is it's taking this joint and it's gonna hold it in place right now, is what the goal of the heel locks and the figure eights are, okay? So we do two, I alternate them. Your notes say to do two heel locks and then two, actually they don't even talk about figure eights, but I'll show you a heel lock, a figure eight, a heel lock and a figure eight, okay? This is where the angles come into play, okay? So we start in the arch of the foot. We're going to come through the arch, through the outside. We want to go behind the ankle bone. Then come up and around. Down behind your other ankle bone. So you can start on the outside or you can start on the inside. I will definitely help you guys with this when you guys do this because it's easier said than done sometimes. Down through the inside, up and over the top of the foot. That's a heel lock. So I've done a strip through the outside here, and I've done a strip through the inside here, okay? The figure eight is a bit easier. We just come in here. So you notice, okay, and then just kind of figure eight around and back. That was a pretty sloppy one. With that being said though, we're less worried about the wrinkles with the heel locks and the figure eights because we have that first layer down, right? So we just have to rub out those wrinkles in through here. Okay? I'm gonna do one more heel lock, one more figure eight. So heel lock down through the middle, up behind the outside ankle bone, up and around the ankle, down through the inside behind the ankle bone again, up and over, okay? This piece of tape wants to go this way, let it go that way. Okay, it doesn't have to come over to the top of the foot, just let it go where it wants to go. Okay, and then one more figure. figure eight to finish off. Okay, so again, just iron out the wrinkles. The big thing to watch for with these tape jobs too, oh, I just wrinkled it, okay. Big thing to watch for with this is as we get into those heel locks and figure eights, we get a little anxious and we want to pull really tight. So you want them to make sure it's not biting in through this area here, just check with the athlete. So I'll get you to step down on it, make sure it's supportive but not biting them in that spot or anywhere in the tape job. Okay, hop back up. So again, you're gonna check that manual check of the function, just relax the foot now. So I'm gonna check to see how much movement he has going inwards. It's better than it was before we did this tape job, so I know that it's doing its job, okay? And then of course I'd get you to do some basketball specific movements, you know, stopping, planting, twisting, anything like that that's gonna may stress that outside of the ankle, okay? Circulation too is gonna be just pinch the toe, it's still there, feels okay? Good. Okay, so let's do this and then we'll jump back after and we'll do one at a time. Okay, so grab some taping supplies from the front and grab a partner and I'll kind of walk around and help you through things. If you want to take that off right now, you can with that guy and cut through the middle behind your bone and then down through the foot.
Yo, how's it going, man?
I'm good, buddy.
There's tongue depressors there if you use for that. Yeah. Oh, there you go. Or that works too.
All right, here we go. Okay.
Grab a partner. I'll just get more.
Oh, you doing this?
Okay.
I'll do these right here.
Let's do it.
You want to go first? Am I seeing that you got it all in your brain or what?
No, you can.
All right, cool.
You can do it.
Have a seat there, buddy.
Good. Don't forget to ask if they've been taped before.
Have I ever been taped?
Yes.
No,
sissy.
What are you doing? Do I need to have put lube on this to order for?
It'll stick better. Yeah. There's the tongue depressor, so you don't have to get your fingers greasy. That's the other thing, too. If you have lotion on as a taper, it's going to be a lot harder to rip that tape.
Slide down for a minute.
It's so scary.
You can put a
9
degrees.
Come on, Tanisha.
Sorry,
guys. I'm
on the edge.
So get him to slide down just a touch more so that you're not fighting with the table.
Okay.
You're doing good, but yeah.
Is that too high for you? Is it good? Oh, I'm going to try.
Don't mind my.
I am not looking. Don't worry. You might want to start a little higher. Yep.
Yeah.
Sure.
I have to cover, I guess, over here as much as possible.
As much as you can, yep. So the good thing about the pre-wrap is that it is flexible and malleable. You can make it make its own corners and turn corners any way it wants. I'll show you. Okay, so this is when you pluck it. So you just take it, and then it magically disappears.
So then, do I have to go back up?
No, you might want to just put a little bit more, get into his heel a little bit, because that's going to get taped off.
Okay.
Good. And just go with whatever way the pre-wrap wants you to go. Yep, that's good.
Question?
Yes.
So this is the bump right here, right?
Right there?
Can you feel it? That's correct, yep.
Okay, so I do right on top of it?
Yeah, so what you can do is, I like to not put the tape kind of right on it.
Oh.
So my first strip I'll put so that the tape is kind of, if this is the bump, yeah, my tape is on either side.
Oh, okay, okay.
There you go.
Good. So the big thing with this one too is make sure that that guy gets covered, right?
This guy right here.
That bump, yeah.
So with those things, is
yes,
this for this?
Yeah, so you, oh yeah, so with those, these horseshoes or the foam padding, if it's a new injury, what you'll do is you could wrap them on before the pro wrap. So you'll spray the ankle and then you put those foam on either side, even if it's just a lateral one, put them on both sides and then do this tape job over top.
Okay, because my teammate, I remember she had to use those
things. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I'll use them just with a tensor bandage throughout the day, but if it's brand new, then you can put this, yeah.
Where do I find this metal, is it right here?
Yep, head of the metatarsal, so just slide down, and there's the bump right there.
And that should be covered, is that what you're
That's saying? Correct. So what I like to do is my first strip will be direct, that metatarsal head will be right in the middle of my strip of tape.
Perfect.
Okay, and don't forget to splay the foot too, right? Because otherwise you can get that toe cramp or the arch cramp. That's when you get to take their big toe and twist it.
No, look at me, you know what, big toe. Kill
me. And then just wrap it around and stop, wrap it around.
We gotta close it, right?
Yeah, so the horseshoes come next. So those are the ones where they start on the inside. They come wrap around to here, and then eventually you'll close it right up to the top.
Can you put lotion on?
So, just one question.
Yes.
I start here? Like
yep.
This? Or do I start like this?
No, it's going to come this way, right? So the tape is going to come down.
Down here.
And then come up on the outside.
Come up on the side?
It'll start out down here, so your horseshoe is going to come around like this, and then eventually they'll close together to the top.
So let's just take a look.
Mm-hmm.
So I start like this, right?
Yeah, I'll show you.
Doing vertical.
That's right. So these strips are closing strips, so they start like this, and you want to hook this guy back here. So you're going to do this first.
Yeah.
Rip. And then I just pull up with that.
I see, yeah.
Okay? Yeah, so then eventually what will happen is as you come up the foot, they're going to come together.
Okay, cool.
Two?
Yep. Well done.
Yeah, Randy's done this before.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
But I want to make sure we get it right.
Yeah.
Okay, now, and then figure it right?
Yes.
Randy, you can probably what?
Okay, how's this so far?
200 angles.
So far, good.
Does it look bad?
Nope, so you did this side and then pulled out, right?
Yeah, like I went that way.
Perfect,
yeah.
Yep.
Okay,
what's next?
The horseshoes, which is the...
So I start...
so you're going to start with the tape end here, and it's going to loop this way onto the outside.
Oh my God.
So these turn into the closing strips.
Right, so I start here, is that what you said?
No, like this way.
Like front to back.
Yeah, like this.
Okay.
And then it's going to loop behind the heel bone and come to the outside.
Like at the bottom of the Like right, is it looping around like right
That's
here?
Right, yeah.
Okay. And is it progressively coming up? Like
yeah, so each time you do it, so you're going to do the first one kind of there, and then you're going to come up the leg
okay.
to close off everything.
Okay. And then you're going to do the...
Should I close this now?
Yeah, no, that's okay.
Yeah?
Yep, you did two figure eights there too? Yeah, good. So the only thing I would do, this might become a hot spot in here,
okay.
just because it's a thin area.
Yep.
So you can do another, if you want to do another figure eight or another heel lock into that area,
okay.
or just take a horseshoe strip and start here and press it down.
Oh yeah? Okay.
Yeah. How are you doing here? Oh, window, hey?
Yeah.
So all you do is you take another piece of tape and you start here and then do a tape, like do a strip around.
Strip around, just,
yeah.
just like right around?
Yeah, just like you did the anchors.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, so it covers it up, okay? Don't be afraid to make these a little bit longer too, so they don't just overlap, they overlap.
Okay, cool.
Fair. But yeah, looks good so far.
And then, so now that I've closed it, now I do the figure eights.
Heel locks and figure eights, yep.
Heel locks and figure eights.
Yep.
That's good. Yeah,
that's
good. Good. Let me have a look. Hop up on the table. Okay. So you check it manually as well, right? You
yep.
want to make
oh,
sure
okay.
that they're...
Okay, yep.
Pull them into that position, so it's really good. I could feel that it's supporting that side, so if he does want to roll over on
yeah,
it that way,
it's going to hold
it. It's going to hold
okay.
it, yeah.
Okay.
No, very well.
Good.
Okay, and just like I said, these little guys here, you just want to
smooth it out.
Smooth it out.
Okay.
Use your nail, whatever, right. just to do that.
Okay.
Okay?
Good.
Good. Okay, so switch partners. You can use the shark. Okay, he can do, let him do
oh,
it.
Okay,
yeah, just because, that's right.
Come down here, I think.
Yeah, come down the outside and then behind your ankle bone and down into the arch.
Compared to the bottom ones? Okay, got it. Thanks, girl.
Just down low. And then
come around and stop here.
Yes.
So know that you won't be a tape expert after this class, but a lot of practice, you know, taking some tape and actually, especially the heel locks and figure eights, because those are the tricky parts.
Especially the ripping.
The ripping, yeah.
Okay.
What do you do that?
No, I'm lost.
Do you pull and then?
Yeah, I guess I can show you that. So here's your little trick to ripping. So put it down. I always use two fingers to stabilize,
yeah.
and you peel off. So here, you take
yeah.
that roll. I'll take another one. So apply the piece. I put, if I'm ripping this way, these are my pinchers,
oh, yeah,
but these
oh,
are my supporters.
Okay.
Yeah, and then.
Oh. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was getting pretty.
Do you think?
Not clean.
Getting sore, yeah.
Yeah, just.
And sometimes the tape does that too. Sometimes if
well,
it's not.
Yeah.
yeah.
Okay.
Right, does
it
start
this way or do I start? Does it matter?
No, you can start outside or inside, whatever is more comfortable. I always start inside.
Okay.
And then you come down through the arch.
Okay.
Up and behind. And around, no, up this way, yeah,
this way? Okay.
And then back, and then behind, and down, and up, boom, just like that. Good job.
How many of those do you do?
Two.
Two.
Yep.
Okay, let's see if I can
one
do
from each side? Or
it doesn't matter, because you do have two heel locks here, right? Like you got one on this side and one on this side,
yeah.
so you just want two of those to okay. support.
So it's under, around.
Yeah, I'll guide you through it when you do it. It's easy. It's when you look at it from this way and then you go and do it the other way, you're like, uh-oh.
Yeah.
All right,
and then one more figure eight.
A figure eight, do we start on the...
I start on the top here. You can start here or here, whatever.
I start like this and then I just can go under and then around.
Yeah.
This.
No, so that's a heel lock again. So you want to come under and up this way,
yeah.
and then behind, around, and then up here.
And around and up.
Yeah. yeah, and then figure eight. See how that eight is happening here, and then down and finish on top, and follow the tape. If the tape wants to go just like that.
Like that.
Yep.
Cool.
Okay. So you just inspect for windows. I just see one right back there.
Yeah.
that would for sure give them a taper.
Yeah, so then I just put it around and I can just go around, right? That's what you're saying.
Did you do two heel locks and two figure eights?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So then what you can do with that one, I would start up here though, not just at that spot.
Yeah.
Start here and do another one of those horseshoes facing this way, sorry.
Cool.
So that, yeah, coming down that way.
Coming down this way?
Yeah.
And then just around here?
Yeah, make sure you get that spot though, right? So up this way a little bit. There you go. Yeah, maybe you want to do one more just to make sure, right? Because one piece of tape, if his sock moves around or his shoe too much, just do a couple to make sure. Okay, and then you check your tape job, make sure that it's functional. So it doesn't have to look pretty as long as it's functional, right? And then you want to move it, right? So that, I'll show you how to, you want to move it that way because that's what you're trying to prevent, right? Is that movement that way. So, right, so you grab that heel like this and just pull, and that's a solid tape job. Good job. Okay? There's a sharp, oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I have a window.
To the wall.
Oh, and you can just, there's a.
No?
Yeah.
You got
that right. To the window.
Wow.
Just mush those two pieces together.
Now, when you get around here, you might have to go around the heel. Yeah, go around.
Yeah.
Bottom.
Yeah.
Okay, check it out, girl.
Yep, that's fine.
Okay.
Good.
It's very loose.
Did you check it?
Yeah, it's not actually that loose at all.
Oh, really?
No.
Maybe a little cold.
I've never had my ankle taped. I've had my arch.
Mm-hmm. Hop up there. I'll just check it.
Are we doing arches today?
Yeah, we are. We're doing arches, wrists, and thumbs.
Okay, Morgan. Let's go.
Okay, so now
great.
Yeah, no, seriously, whenever you're talking about stuff, I was like, yeah, that's not me, I don't like that. And I usually get two in the bag, but you can just
get two of these?
Yeah, I'm just kidding.
No,
are you serious right now, Morgan?
No, seriously, because my basketball shoes, I have two in the bag.
I thought you were just messing with it.
Follow the
athlete. Yep.
No, I actually had to put two.
No, it's
not like this.
Oh, no, it was like this. Oh, it's not.
Probably too much, yeah.
How many layers did you do? Might be a little bit too much into here.
Till I had, and I just messed up in there. So.
Yeah, that's okay though.
That's okay.
Just as long as you know that you have a little bit more layer in here, so you want to make sure that tape is secure.
Okay.
Okay.
Same idea as this. Another two more strips. So you put an anchor.
When you're working with that tape, sometimes it's easier just to pull it and, you know, so you're not kind of rolling it off as you go.
Like
yeah, and then you can wrap it around. It's a lot easier that way.
Have you ever taped tape?
No.
Okay, you're doing a good job.
Same thing, yeah? Just on the other side.
Well,
yeah, we're on. You said two anchors on there?
Yeah. Yeah, make sure you've got that bone covered, right?
Okay. So now she wants to go from the inside out. Okay, because you've got to go from here.
Okay.
Inside out. So you mean like...
Yes,
because you want to spray like this. You send this like
yeah.
So see how fast they do it here.
Yeah, my
so you have to go
biting down here.
Make sure the next one goes inside to outside.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay. So if you mess up like that, that's okay. What you do is you just anchor that one down. You just tack it down. Then you. Okay. right? Because you want to be pulling it. That's right. So you release this one, and then you want to pull up that way. There you go. Now you've just switched it from, you never want to go lateral to medial, because that's just going to put them into that more, that provocative position that they don't want to be in.
Mm-hmm.
Or you don't want them to be in.
Move it down. Yep.
Yeah.
And
then do it again. Another one. Good. There. Yeah. I think this is in a recent
English. Yeah.
This takes practice, though.
I don't know.
It does.
Yeah. And, you know.
Did you guys offer it? Offer like this kind of stuff at Oak Park?
I did. I tried. But I used to bring my kids down to Ben Trunzel and Glenn Bergeron. I took advantage of the expert, and then I practiced. Like she said, you got if you practice, you'll get. Like, he is a good
builder. What next? Horseshoes, right?
The stirrups. Yep. So you want to start on the inside and then strip it out to the outside.
Because I know lots of schools in Calgary do it at like high schools or whatever. But
start on the inside.
I first see we never did.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Kids loved it. Kids loved it.
I think of the kids that do leadership at FRC, just from like student teaching there, and I'm like, I don't know.
We did anatomy, we did, right after anatomy, we did athletic injuries, which makes sense, right?
Yeah.
You learn the anatomy and then you try and teach athletic injuries, right?
Yes.
So this one right here.
Yep.
Do I do it a little bit more of an angle?
No, just if you follow this, if you follow like the half width and go that way, eventually it's just going to come together.
Yeah.
And then that's fine right there?
Well, not really. He wants it, but that could be the shape of your foot as well. So not everybody has the same shape of foot, and the tape doesn't want to sit properly on everybody's feet, especially if you had a really flat arch. Where are you? So go where the tape wants to go. If the tape, wants to go there. Why does the tape want to go there? Because of his foot?
Yeah, the heel.
Okay. Okay, bring it. Yeah, just to there. That's fine then. So it only overlaps then a little bit. You're going to anchor over here. Okay.
Good. Okay, and then the next one.
Yeah, so if you have somebody who's got, so what you want to do with this one, just bring it and start it over here a little bit more, right? Because we're trying to close off everything now. Yeah.
Yeah, and then once
you get to that side, his foot doesn't want to go that way. Okay, let me just take that, finish that strip, and I'm going to try the next one. I'll see if it's his foot or maybe the way. Because ideally what you want to do is be coming up this way, right? Okay. Oh, yeah, so from going from this angle, you want to start doing this.
Yeah.
Now, and then it'll come up and around where you want it to be. Okay. So this strip down here, if you want to do one below it, just angle it more this way as it comes around.
Even then
it's still, oh yeah, I think that's the shape of his foot. So you have to fight the tape a little bit with that one. So I'm going to take that piece off just because it makes it really messy. But not everybody has the same shape foot, obviously, right? So just follow what the tape wants to do, but try and work around it as well. You may get, that's where you're going to get the wrinkles. And then
start from here and work the other way.
You can.
This way.
Is it smoother that way?
Still wants to. Down.
Okay, just got to work past his heel, and then it should work its way out.
It should be okay now.
So I'm going to guess that you might have a challenge with your heel locks and figure eights because of the shape of his foot.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Use your whole foot. There you go. Relax the toes and just bring the foot there.
Other way, like up top. So have it more, but it's up front.
Yeah, there you go.
Remember, and then it just kind of comes.
It goes this way. And then to the other side.
Oh, yeah. That's what I'm doing. I'm like looking at it, I'm like, I don't know if that's the right way. I'm kind of
so there, like,
yep. So you're starting there, right? This is the one that's going to go behind the heel bone and then to the outside.
No.
OK. Okay. So, and when you're using the tape, sometimes it's easier to give yourself a little bit of leeway. So if I'm taping her, I'm going to give myself a little bit, as opposed to having it nice and tight, because then you, it just works easier.
So am I like, as I go further?
You'll eventually get there. So I would do one more just a little further than the last one. And then you'll start closing up through the top.
How'd that feel?
Good.
Yeah?
That was a good heel lock.
Yeah, it was.
Did you do two?
No. Nope.
One on each side?
Though? That was my first one.
Oh, yeah, you got it, though. Yep. Okay, keep going.
I'll figure it is here, from here, right?
Yep. You might want to start that a little bit lower on the foot, just because the X of the figure eight should come through the front of the ankle here.
So here?
Yeah. Come back down and under this way. I know the tape doesn't want to, so that's okay. You've done half a figure eight right now. You can rip the tape if you want to.
Okay, or?
Or, well, that's, or else you go around one more time.
Oh, and then.
Or you can come around and then come down, right?
So if I ripped it there.
So then you can still start it here, but different angle. Because you want to be coming, you want to come behind it and then down this way, right?
So you come around this way and then around that way?
That's right.
Okay. I just three.
There you go. Yeah, yeah. And then down.
Like this.
Yeah. So that's the second half of your figure eight.
I need help with the heel locks.
Heel locks? Yeah. Okay. So want me to show you and then you can follow it?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So I would stop using that tape. Yeah. It just gets harder to use when it gets to the bottom. Okay, so your heel, I always start on the inside arch, it's easiest for me.
Yep.
So you're going to come underneath, mm-hmm.
Sorry.
Behind the ankle bone here, okay? And then up and around, okay? Down through the inside, and then up and over. Okay, you want to just follow that line. So that was a bad angle here, we iron out everything. So you're going to start. Where did my starting point go? I should have colored the tape. You'll start here, so to do another one. So you're going to angle here, come down the foot, okay? Behind the ankle bone here, up and around, down through the middle, up and finish.
That's not moving that way.
Okay, want to try? I'll guide you.
This is confusing.
Heel locks are the hardest, in my opinion.
Yeah, they are.
They're hard to teach too, because it's like, you know, up and around and a down and around. You're going to go the other way. So you're going this way through the arch, and you'll come out through the outside of the foot.
Under the foot.
Behind this ankle bone.
Yeah, behind the ankle.
So this is all about angles, right? So, behind and then around the ankle. Give yourself a little bit of leeway with that tape too, right? If you do it so tight, it's going to be extra tight. Give yourself some space with that. Okay. Around this way. Okay, and down. No, right around. Yeah, you're, no, you're good because we did this one.
Right.
And then you're gonna come down this way, behind.
And horseshoe around there, kind of.
Down. No, yeah, no, you want to come behind this.
Oh, behind
that guy there.
Okay.
So if we get stuck here, that's okay. If the tape's not listening to you, rip the tape, and then you can start again from that side.
Okay.
Yep. Because sometimes the angle just doesn't work.
Yeah.
And instead of fighting with the tape. You can just rip it and then start again.
This is the frustrating part.
Yeah. I think you're hooped now because you folded it. That's okay. Try from the other side first.
I was just wondering.
Messed it up. Sorry, you can get it. No. Hey, you don't need scissors. That's hard. That's hard.
Thanks.
Yeah. So you just got to angle and get the other side.
So where am I in? I'm here.
You
know, I got to go down. Right?
So yeah. So what you came up around this way, right?
Yeah,
so but you have to finish the heel lock on this side.
Okay.
Hang on. I got to think about this here. I'm coming around this way, up and around. So you're coming. You can start up here, come around, down, and then up.
I think a lot of our age level will be looked at.
Does the heel locks, do they go under
probably
first?
Like
yes.
And then around? Yeah. And then
under, behind?
Around?
Yeah, you gotta angle it. Yeah, angle it down, down, down. Yeah, you got it.
On the ball, around my heel.
And then around the, be underneath the foot again.
Underneath the foot and up on top. There you go. Just got the angle a little bit.
Yeah.
You got it.
That's what the heel locks are all about, the angles. As soon as you get the right angle, it's real like.
Now you should prepare up good.
Yeah, yep.
That's it.
Do you want to go? You want to go down at that point? Yeah. No, no. You're right. 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 No, you're right.
Okay.
You were so right. You were doing so well.
You had it, girl.
Yeah, you had it.
They just really brought down the confidence.
Aw.
Okay.
Come on, team players.
Starting right here in the middle, right?
Yep. So you go down, and you're gonna come up behind the ankle bone. Behind and around the top of the foot.
Above the ankle bone or just?
If it doesn't want to, don't. It just goes wherever you want it to go, where it wants to go.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, you're doing so well.
Crinkling and stuff.
I know. Sorry. Griffith, under the mat.
What's that?
Try through the inside first. Sometimes that helps the angle a little bit more. Yep, so I'll show you. My angle would be kind of this. Because I'm going to come under and behind. Yep.
Adam ordered it, not me.
Behind. Up and around, right around the top here. Good. Yeah, you're good. Yep, come right back, and then you're going to come down this way. Down under the foot. Oh, you're totally getting it. And then up, and you're done. And then that's your... And then that's your heel lock. Cut the tape right there. I'll show you. Here's how you tape. Cut. Rip it easy. Use these fingers as a holder. Pinch them and go. That's your heel lock, yeah. So we just work out those wrinkles, which are going to come with the first couple that you do. That's fine. Do another heel lock and then a two figure eights.
Okay.
We can snip it. What do you think here?
It's going to loosen up. Let me check. Just relax the foot.
First time.
You relax your foot. Yeah, that's not bad.
First time. That's
well done. So then you get him to do functional stuff as well, right? Make sure that it's working and when he's pivoting, planting, things like that.
Yeah.
Pushing off.
Pretty good. Good job. I can't remember what you said.
No?
For the heel lock?
Yeah.
Okay.
So
inside.
Under.
Yeah.
Around.
Yeah, start here. You're going to come into the arch. And then up behind the bone back there.
Yeah.
And up and around. Yeah. Up and around. Give yourself some tape. There you go. And around. If it wants to go up there, let it go up there. We can guide it back down afterwards.
Okay.
Yeah. And then around.
Gosh.
Right around. Or if you want to, you can rip
it.
Yeah, you sure can. Like this.
I don't know if it's good or bad. So then I'll just start there, right?
So starting here, yeah, but you want to change the angle, right? Because obviously that angle, you don't like that angle. So you'll start going this way because you're going to come around and then around the heel.
Sorry, where?
You're coming around this way.
This way?
To come down. Yep, you're going.
Oh my God.
You're good.
What in the? Dan, I hope you have a lot of tape for the summer.
It's looking good so far, yeah. So from here.
I'm doing great.
From here. And then you're going to come down and around behind the back here. Heel lock down here. And yeah, see this angle here is what you want. So you can change up that tape angle. You can start it lower if you want.
So like right here?
Yeah.
Okay, so
there you go. Boom. Down and under.
Under.
Yep, and then up and over top, and there's your heel lock.
Girl, you're gonna have some long times down there.
I know, right? It's so high.
It's a little tight here, but that's okay. That's what practice does.
Three levels.
Good, and then two figure eights.
More tape.
She's just in the wrong hotel.
So starting here, right?
Yeah, you can start up top or you can start down at the bottom. It's whatever way you want. And just see how.
Maybe I'll get still.
December report card is ready, and then another one at the end, like, too. You can give him something to work on in a second. I walk into school and then you gotta.
You might want to get a new roll.
Yeah, once you get to the end of the roll, it's no. Hi. You practicing on the other ankle? Fantastic. I would start just a little higher than what you did there. Yeah. Next time.
Yeah, it's broken. Don't touch.
Not permanent in.
Yes.
Okay. So the next one we'll do is the arch support. This is kind of one of the basics because it's one of the simpler tape jobs to do, but I wouldn't do this again unless the doctor or the therapist has suggested that they get this tape job done, because if they actually don't need the arch support done and you do it, you can mess things up right up to their low back, so you don't want to do that, right? With this one though, I'll show you the tape job, we'll practice it quickly. It'll be more uncommon that you'll see this one, but it's a good one to know, okay? Can I get a person? Please, anybody? With this one, you'll use the skin toughener again. You'll use the zinc oxide tape again. If you have an unlimited budget and you have all the tape supplies in the world, you can use moleskin. That's what this is called. It's like felty on one side and then it's adhesive on the other side. That'll be for the back to protect the Achilles tendon. For the sake of today and for the sake of real life, you can use a heel and lace pad back behind behind the heel. Okay, so what I'll get you to do is just sitting back on the table, and with this one her foot is relaxed completely because we want the arch to be completely relaxed the whole time we do that. Okay, do you want the spray again or do you want me to do it without the spray? It's fine? Okay. So we'll do spray, bottom of the foot. Make sure you use a lot of this. If their foot gets any, it gets sweaty, it's not going to work. Okay. We don't use the pre-wrap behind this tape job because it won't support like we want it to. We want this to have maximal support under the arch, so we do it right to the skin. They generally don't seem to care because their feet get sweaty and it'll come off for the most part anyway. So heel and lace pad, I just would fold one in half and stick it behind the Achilles tendon there. Make sure it's there. If it's too bulky for them, it shouldn't be. You can cut it in half, okay? I'll fight with that in a second. So you're gonna do, anchors for this one are gonna be just below the toes. If you look at the ball of the foot, just come to the back, the base of that. Don't go into the ball of the foot with this one, because then you'll impede that toe movement, which we don't want to do. Okay, so we wrap around this way here. I'm gonna cut this in half just for the sake of.
Is moleskin sticky on?
It is. So it's felt on the one side, and then the back peels off, and it'll attach right to the skin. Okay, so that'll go back there. Okay, so this is your one anchor is at the foot. The other anchor, it's easier to do it with half the width of this tape. I like to do it that way anyway. So just rip the tape in half, and then it easily peels off. And then this is your anchor the other way. It goes inside to outside. It doesn't matter. This tape is just being laid down. There's no tension really applied to it. Okay, it goes behind and then to the other side.
So basically a horseshoe again,
right? You're right. Okay. There's multiple different taping materials you can use for this. Hypofix is another one. It's like a felty, I have it right here. Oops. It's kind of felty but extra sticky, and that's a good anchor as well for on the foot, especially if they've got sensitive skin or they don't like the bulkiness around the foot of the white tape. This is like a piece of cloth that sticks. It sticks really well too. Okay, so I've got my two anchors down. I've got my anchors around the toes or the foot, and then behind the heel. So what I want to do next is I want to support that medial arch. And that medial arch is this guy in here. That's the one that's most commonly collapses on people, like flat feet that you see. That's the arch that's collapsed. So a real simple way to get this arch to lift is you're going to start from the outside, the anchor on the outside of the foot, which is the same as this guy here. You're going to start from the outside and pull. Again, you don't want to crunch that foot together. So if you just grab and pull, we're going to collapse the foot. We don't want to do that. So lay down the tape, lay down the tape halfway to the foot, the middle of the foot. When you get to where the medial arch is, you're going to pull up. Okay? And then rip the tape and attach it to that anchor there. Okay? We do as many strips as it takes to cover, depending on how big the foot is, to cover that whole arch. But we just come down the foot. Okay? Overlap by half, lay down the tape, pull up, and then lay down the tape. Okay? Always, so get to the middle of the foot here, just laying down the tape, and then apply a pressure to lift that arch. Okay, I'm gonna do one more. Okay, same thing with the heel. We want to make sure that we don't squish the heel when we're doing this, because that could cause some irritation. So lay it down, pull up, and tack it down. Okay, so she's got three in there. It's pulling a bit in there, but that'll loosen up a little bit when she starts to move around a bit. You got to remember that as well. Zinc oxide tape, it's cloth, so when it gets wet, it actually does stretch out just a little bit. Okay, and then from there, we do what we call teardrops. So half the width again. You're going to start, so where the ball of her foot is, we're going to start just to the inside of that, kind of the center of her foot, and we start one through there, come around the back of the foot, and we teardrop it to the middle, and we attach it there. Okay? So again, that pull this way, it's just because the arch through the middle is kind of like a fan shaped, so we want to make sure that we get all support that we can. Okay, so you do a couple of like that, you can just kind of fan it out around the back. Close it in there. And then you can close off those strips. I'll just do this. So then you only need to close off on one strip because these teardrops are holding everything else in place. So we just do one more across the top. Okay, that's your arch teardrop. So you can step down, you can feel that it'll pull up. It should feel like it's pulling up on your arch when you step down.
Yep.
Okay, the big thing with this tape job is you want to make sure that it's not pulling, just put your foot up for a second, please. That is not pulling in the back of the Achilles. You don't want to irritate the Achilles in the back. So make sure that when she steps down, it's not feeling like it's really pulling in the back there. She'll feel like, you're going to feel like it's supporting it, but it shouldn't feel like it's digging into it. Okay? Let's try the arch and then we'll go from there. Can I have a wrist? Yours? Oh, okay.
I want to go.
You want to go.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to show you guys how to tape her wrist to prevent hyperextension, which is back this way. And that's what's going to be most, you know, when you fall down on the court, that's what's going to hurt the most is in through this position here. Okay? So, doesn't matter which side we do. I'm going to be kind and not use the skin toughener. Again, this is another one of those tape jobs that you'll probably want to do right to the skin for best support, just because the hands get pretty sweaty, and the wrist can get pretty sweaty. So you want to, but we'll be kind today, and I'm going to use some pre-wrap and then the zinc oxide. Okay? So it's her wrist that's bugging her. I'm going to move that. It hurts her when she gets into this position here. So the first thing I want to do is I want to do anchors for her, but I'm going to put this is not happening, right? This is just for our sake here.
You can spray it if you want.
But sometimes, don't they, like I've had wrist tape skip jobs and I've had for a
You can. It's best, and you'll get the most support with just this, the skin toughener and on your skin. Okay? So I'll just wrap it on here. Yep. Spread the hands wide apart. Again, you don't want them to get that gorilla hand where it gets squished in together. So spread the hands wide apart when we're doing this part here, and we'll come through the web space. Some people don't like it into the palm of the wrist. Unfortunately, with a wrist tape job, you have to get into the palm of the hand. So you'll apply your two anchors. Distally into the forearm. With this one, again, you don't want to be too tight, because then you're going to impede that movement of the fingers, right? Because you're going to tighten up all those muscles in there with the tape. So you can get them to this, or you can get them to make a fist if you feel like you don't have too much control over the tape. So you can make a fist and really squeeze it together, and then that way I know I've got the muscles at their bulkiest. Okay, and then you're going to splay the hands out. So that's the proximal anchor. Your distal anchor is going to come through the hand. Just put your hand up that way. So the one thing we want to be very careful of is the web space between the thumb and the index finger. So what I do with the tape, we call kissing it, or you can just fold it over. It's easier to do it with your lips. Just fold over that piece so that the edge of the tape doesn't cut your fingers, or cut the web space. And then we're just going to lay that again. We don't want to pull too tight, because if we bunch her finger together, then she's not functional as a basketball player, right? So fingers splayed apart, make sure that we're just laying down this piece. And we do that, okay? That's all you need to do for your two anchors, okay? Then you're going to make a fan, and this is going to be done off of their skin. So you take 3-4 strips, however many you want. You can measure out the distance. So we want to prevent this back motion, so we're going to tape on this, the X on this side. If we want to prevent this motion, we're going to tape on the back of the hand, okay? So just hold your hand out there so I know the distance that I need, about that big. So each strip, here's where you can do it just on the table. So lay out your pieces. Okay, and then you're going to make a fan. So just like so, like an X like that through the middle, and then one more piece the opposite way. Okay, so that's only 3 pieces. You can do 3. So I've got an X like an asterisk, right? Straight piece, and then 2 X's. That's called a fan. I might throw, depending on how aggressive she is a player, how strong she is, I'll throw an extra few pieces, okay? So what I want to do is I want to lay down, I'll do it this way, we'll lay down the first piece. You can do it either from the close or the proximal end or the distal end, it doesn't matter. Lay down that one piece, anchor it down. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to find where it hurts her. So if it hurts her here, we want to pull her back from that position and then pull that fan down and attach it. So we know that it won't go any further than that. Okay? So we lay it down and then we anchor it up. So again, you can get them to make a fist so that you're not cutting off any circulation. Always overlapping by a half when you're doing your anchors. Okay, and then straighten out. So then we're going to test it functionally again to make sure. So this feels a little bit loose right now. What I would do is I wouldn't take it off. I would add 3 more fans and then wrap it up again. If you do more than that, it's too bulky. You've got to take off the tape job and start it all over again. Okay? Go.
That's for the wrist, right?
That's for the wrist. So that's preventing that hyper extension this way.
And so, say if we don't want to do, like, you know how you did the 3, the fan or whatever?
Yeah.
Is there, like, do we have to do it like that? Like, where we do
No, there's another variation to do it. Okay. Just got to be cautious, and you always want that X of the fan to be right over that wrist area. So another way to do that is you put your pieces down, and then this just involves a little bit more. So you're kissing again, coming through here. I like, and then I'll come this way, and then wrap around. Yes.
Okay.
So you either do it fan, oop, there we go. And then I'll come from this side and same thing, but I got to make sure that my angles are right so that my fan intersects at the wrist joint, okay? And around that way, okay? So that's another way to do it, or you can add those strips on if you want to. That's not part of the of your package, but if you find that the fan isn't helping enough, then you can do those couple strips, and you still have to close them off though to anchor them
right
in. Okay, let's try that.
Who are you trying
to? If you want to spray each other, you can. You don't need the wrist stuff if you don't want to, but if you're going to use the underwrap in real life, then you're going to want to use the spray as well.
Okay, I don't want spray though.
No,
Yeah, let's take this off. Yeah, and then I'll do. So a really quick and simple wrist tape job that you guys can do to help, again, with that, just with that last range. Now, this is if that person is feeling really good. They're probably at 90%, but that just that last little bit. We call it the Wonder Woman tape job. But and so I'm just going to be kind and put the pro wrap on her or the pre-wrap on now. But if you're going to tape your athlete, it's going right to their skin. Okay? So basically what you're doing with this one is you're just doing strips around the wrist. So you're going to hold your hand down like this. I'm going to pull the tape across, so you know, a width that's going to come right around her wrist. You're going to go right into that wrist crease where the wrist folds. That's where your first strip is going to go, right into the, almost into the palm of the hand. So I'm going to place it. I'm going to tell you to push down onto the wrist, and then I'm going to fold it over itself. Okay, push down. Get them to do it really, really strong, and then you just do multiple strips like that, push down. Okay, and then push down again. Okay, you can bulk it up a little bit more. This is for those athletes who really don't like anything in the palm of their hand. I mean, it's better for them. And then push down again, push down real hard. Good. That was overkill there. Okay, but this one's gonna prevent that motion as well. Okay, as long as you get high enough, sorry, flip your wrist around. As long as you get high enough into the hand, then that's gonna prevent that extension as well. Okay, that's your other wrist option. You can stay up here, we'll take that off. Let's move on to thumb, which is the last tape job I'll be showing you today. So there are, again, there are variations to all these tape jobs. The main thing is that with anything, even if you don't remember them step by step when you're doing them on your own, as long as they're functional and they do the job that you want them to do, right? And don't put them into more harm. So you want to make sure that they're not, you're not, those windows are the big ones. You're not putting them into position that's going to harm them. And so that's a big one with the thumb. So the thumb is our opposing finger, right? We need it to come across our hands. The big thing that happens and the biggest mistake that happens when people are taping thumbs is they get really aggressive with it and they pull the thumb into this position, which you don't want to have, right? That's not a very functional position for us to have. You're not going to be able to play sports with your thumb in through that position. The other one is if it's pulled way back out here. That puts it into more a more provocative position or more a position that's going to get them into trouble with spraining it even more or dislocations or things like that. So you want to make sure that it's not way out here, but it's not tucked in tight there either. Okay? Again, for the sake of demonstration, we'll use the toughener. You'll spray the toughener. We'll use the pre-wrap. This little trick that Morgan showed me, or didn't show me, but reminded me. You can poke a little hole in the pre-wrap and wrap it through the thumb, and then it gets less bulky in the web space when you're wrapping it on. She may have had her thumb taped a time or two in her career.
Maybe a few times.
Okay, oh, I pinched it a little bit, that's okay. Okay, so anchors go down first. First anchor is going to go into the wrist. Make sure you splay your hand out or make it into a fist, whatever works better for you. I'll do a couple of those. Okay, and then you're going to splay your hand out. So most commonly, you're going to injure it going backwards, right, in basketball. It's going to clip off your thumb and sprain it backwards. So we do want to make sure that it's coming forward, but in a functional position. Functional position means they should still be able to hold on to a cup or a glass when their thumb is taped. Okay? So for her, we want to find that position. Okay, so it hurts kind of back in through here. So we're going to bring her forward just a little bit. We're not going to pull it too far forward because then we're going to get into that position, which we don't want, right? So we're going to get her into a functional position where your hand is like that. And then I'm going to do the teardrops that we did with the arch. We're going to do them on the thumb as well, okay? So you can pre-measure it if you want to, if that's easier for you to use the tape. One anchor before we start those check reins, so kiss that tape in the middle again to protect the web space, and then come down onto those anchors. That's just for all your tape to attach to. Another one with this tape, because we're going to be wrapping right around the thumb, it's really important to check the circulation as you're taping it, because we can get into really tight, getting it tight around the thumb and losing circulation in there. So each time you apply a piece of tape, just check the circulation to make sure that it's still flowing pretty well. Okay. Okay, so I want to prevent this motion from happening here. So I'm going to come through her finger. This joint here, we don't want to affect that if we don't have to, okay? Otherwise she loses the movement in the thumb. So we stick to the tape's getting stuck to this bone here, okay? In between the two joints. You lay down a piece, kind of anchored on, so the teardrop is a little off-centered, if that makes sense, but we're still going in that direction. So we're going to do one, lay it down this way. And every time we lay down one way, we have to do the opposite direction to balance it out, because we're kind of making a cast for the thumb. Okay, so I'm going to have to go this way now. This is the more important piece because it's going to pull that thumb forward a little bit more. Okay, so we're going to want to pull a little bit tighter on that side and bring it in. Okay, we check her thumb, make sure she's still got circulation in it, and you can check the function as you go along too to make sure that you're applying it properly. Okay, we're making sure I'm not pulling her into that position there, which is not happening. And you keep going with these strips. You do about six of them back and forth. How's that feeling? Good still? Mm-hmm. I just did that way. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's a little bit too much, so we want to ease off of that a bit and then just lay the tape down. So always checking that function after each strip that you're doing. Okay, I'll do one more just to make sure. With the tape on the thumb too, it tends to get really bulky if you don't overlap it. You know, if you overlap it directly, like 100%, so we want to get that 50% overlap again so that we're not making it too bulky in through the thumb. Okay. Ooh, we're bunched up there. Okay. And then you'll take your full strips again and you're going to do your closing strips. So start at the thumb as close as you can. Close it off. You're going to come up into the thumb as well, into the hood of thumbs, to prevent that movement from happening. My thumb doesn't do it, but that movement from happening. So you're going to come right up into the thumb. These are like those horseshoe strips that we've been doing this whole time. Thank you. And we'll do one more into the thumb. Okay. Half strip to close off those hoods. And then close off the tape job. So we make sure she's still functional, she's still got circulation happening in her thumb. As long as she's got, even if it's a little bit slower, that's okay, because that's going to loosen up as she starts moving a little bit more. As long as she's got some circulation in there as you first start, then that's fine. And then she can rip off that pre-wrap from her palm so her palm is still free. Okay? Let's try that. It's the last one.